Hello students, how are you? Again welcome to my class. Now today we will discuss about one new topic, comparing and ordering of like fraction. I hope that all are familiar with like fraction. That means fraction having same denominator. Fraction having same denominators are called like fraction. For example, 7 upon 9, 5 upon 9, 10 upon 9, 8 upon 9. All these fractions belong to like fraction. That's why denominators are same. Okay? So, like fraction means a fraction having with same denominators are called like fraction. A fraction having with same denominator are called like fraction. Okay. So this is the example of like fraction. But your topic is comparing and ordering. Okay. That means how we will compare these four fractions. Compare means which fraction is bigger, which fraction is smaller, how we will compare. So keep in mind, if you have like fraction, okay, if you have more than like fraction, then it is very easy to compare to the given fraction to each other. Please keep in mind, if you have many like fraction, okay, and in that condition it is very easy to compare to the fraction with each other. Okay, how? Look here. This is 7 upon 9, 5 upon 9, 11 upon 9, 10 upon 9. Okay, in all these fractions, what you are looking, denominators are same. That is 9. Okay, so suppose this is the fourth fraction. Okay. And these four fractions we can write in increasing order. That means I have one question. How can you write these four fractions in increasing order? Now look here. What is the meaning of increasing order? Increasing order means smallest to biggest. Increasing order means smallest to biggest. Okay. So now look here. Now we will compare only with numerator. This is 7, this is 5, this is 10, and this is 8. And increasing order means smallest to biggest. So in all these numerator, which is the smallest numerator? That is 5. So first is 5 upon 9. Okay. Then after 5, which number comes there? 7 upon 9. 7 upon 9. Then after 8 upon 9. And then after 10 upon 9. So this is the increasing order of the given like fraction. This is the increasing order of the given like fraction. So this is the comparison, okay, and ordering. 5 upon 9 and this is 7 upon 9. Please keep in mind, 5 is less than 7. 5 is less than 7. So 5 upon 9 is less than 7 upon 9. 7 upon 9 is less than 8 upon 9. 8 upon 9 is less than 10 upon 9. Okay. 5 upon 9 is less than 7 upon 9. 7 upon 9 is less than 8 upon 9. 8 upon 9 is less than 10 upon 9. Okay. So this is the increasing order of the given like fraction. Okay, then you have वन मोर क्वेश्चन, हाउ कैन यू राइट दीज फोर फ्रैक्शंस इन डिक्रीजिंग ऑर्डर? सो नाउ लुक हियर, डिक्रीजिंग ऑर्डर मीन्स बिगेस्ट टू स्मॉलेस्ट. डिक्रीजिंग ऑर्डर मीन्स बिगेस्ट टू स्मॉलेस्ट. डेट मीन्स डिक्रीजिंग ऑर्डर इज इनवर्स ऑफ इंक्रीजिंग ऑर्डर. सो इन ऑल दीज फोर फ्रैक्शन विच इज द बिगेस्ट फ्रैक्शन? बिगेस्ट फ्रैक्शन इज 10 upon 9. ओके, नाउ देन आफ्टर 8 upon 9, then after 7 upon 9, and then after 5 upon 9. That means 10 upon 9 is greater than 8 upon 9, 8 upon 9 is greater than 7 upon 9, 7 upon 9 is greater than 5 upon 9. So this is the decreasing order of the given like fraction. Okay, this is the increasing order of the given like fraction, and this is the decreasing order of the given like fraction. Now your second topic is comparing and ordering of unlike fraction. Your next topic is comparing and ordering of unlike fraction. Okay, what is the meaning of unlike fraction? A fraction having with different denominator are called unlike fraction. A fraction having with different denominator are called unlike fraction. As you are looking, 11 upon 12, 1 upon 3 and 5 upon 8. These are the example of unlike fraction. That's why denominators are different. Okay, so this is the question number 1B from your book, page number 58. Okay, your question is, arrange the fraction in increasing order. Arrange the fraction in increasing order. So how can you write these fraction in increasing order? So what will you do? This is 11 upon 12, this is 1 upon 3, and this is 5 upon 8. It is very difficult. It is very difficult to arrange the given fraction in increasing order. So what will you do? Your first step is, first we will make the denominator equal. First we will make the denominator equal. And how we will make the denominator equal? How we will make the denominator equal? By the help of LCM. So first we will take LCM of 12, 3 and 8. Okay, now look here. LCM of 12, 3 and 8 will be, this is 2. I hope that all are familiar with LCM. We have already discussed in previous chapter. 2, 6 are 12, this is 3, 2, 4 are 8, again this is 2, 2, 3 are 6, 3, 2, 2 are 4, 2, 3, 3, 2, 1 are 2, 3 1 are 3. Okay, so LCM will be 2 into 2 into 2 into 3. Two two is a 4, 4 two is a 8, 8 three is a 24. LCM is 24. Okay, LCM is 24. That means this is 11 upon 12. This is 11 upon 12. Okay, and denominator is 12. So what will you do? 12 converted to 24. We will 12 convert to 24. Now look here, 11 upon 12. You know very well, 12 2s are 24. So 11 into 2 upon 12 into 2. 11 2s are 22, 12 2s are 24. Okay. Then after this is 1 upon 3. 3 converted to 24. How will you convert 3 to 24? Now look here, 3 8s are 24. 3 8s are 24. So 1 multiplied by 8 upon 3 multiplied by 8. 8 1 is 8. 3 8s are 24. Okay. Then after this is 5 upon 8. Okay. And how will you convert 8 to 24? You know very well, 8 3 is 24. 5 into 3 upon 8 into 3. 5 3 is 15, 8 3 is 24. 5 3 is 15, 8 3 is 24. Okay. So, as you are looking, 11 upon 12 is equal to 22 upon 24. 1 upon 3 is equal to 8 upon 24. 5 upon 8 is equal to 15 upon 24. That means this is the unlike fraction, okay? And by the help of LCM, unlike fraction converted to like fraction. By the help of LCM, unlike fraction converted to like fraction. Then in this condition, easily we can arrange the given fraction in increasing order. In increasing order. How? Look here. This is 22 upon 24, 8 upon 24, 15 upon 24. In all these fractions, denominators are same. That means these three fractions are like fraction. These three fractions are like fraction. Okay? And like fraction, we can easily arrange in increasing order. How? Look here. We will discuss about only numerator. This is 22, this is 8, and this is 15. Okay? In 22, 8, and 15, which is the biggest number? 22. So, first fraction is 22 upon 24, okay? Then after, which number is less than 22 in these three fraction? 15. 15 upon 24. Then after, in last, 8 upon 24, okay? But this is the incomplete answer. This is the incomplete answer. That's why your question is in the form of these three fractions. So what will you do? This is 22 upon 24. 22 upon 24 is equal to 11 upon 12. 22 upon 24 represent 11 upon 12. 15 upon 24 represent 5 upon 8. 8 upon 24 represent 1 upon 3. Okay. That means 11 upon 12, then after 5 upon 8, and then after 1 upon 3. First 11 upon 12, second 5 upon 8, and third is 1 upon 3. This is the increasing order of the given fraction. Now look here. 11 upon 12 is bigger than 5 upon 8. 5 upon 8 is bigger than 1 upon 3. Okay. So, this is the required answer for the given question. This is your question number 1C from your book page number 58. In this question, Arrange the fraction in increasing order. Arrange the given fraction in increasing order. So what will you do? We will apply the same procedure. As you are looking, these three fractions are unlike fraction. That's why denominators are different. Okay. So first, what will you do? First, we will make the denominator equal. First, we will make the denominator equal by the help of LCM. So, we will take out LCM of, 5, 4 and 10. Okay. This is 2, this is 5, 2, 2 is 4, 2, 5 is 10. Okay. Then after, this is 2, 5, 2, 1 is 2 and this is 5. This number is divisible by 5, 5, 1 is 5. And 5 1 is 5. Okay. Then after LCM will be 2 into 2 into 5. 2 into 2 into 5. 2 2 is 4. 4 5 is 20. 2 2 is 4. 4 5 is 20. LCM is 20. LCM is 20. So LCM is 20 and your first fraction is 1 upon 5. So what will you do? We will 5 converted to 20. So 5 4 is 20. 5 4 is 20. That means 1 multiplied by 4 and 5 multiplied by 4. 4 1 is 4. 5 4 is 20. Second fraction is 3 upon 4. 4 5 is 20. How we will convert 4 to 5? 4 5 is 20. That means 3 multiplied by 5 and 4 multiplied by 5. 3 5 is 15. 4 5 is 20. Okay. Then after 3 upon 10, 10 converted to 20. How? Multiplied by 2. 3 into 2 upon 10 into 2. 3 to the 6, 10 to the 20. Okay. Now look here. 1 upon 5 is equal to 4 upon 20. 3 upon 4 is equal to 15 upon 20. 3 upon 10 is equal to 6 upon 20. That means 1 upon 5 and 4 upon 20 are equal. 3 upon 4 and 15 upon 20 are equal fraction. 3 upon 10 and 6 upon 20 are equal fraction. So, your question is in which form? Unlike fraction form. Your question is in form of unlike fraction. Okay. And by the help of LCM, what did you do? Unlike fraction converted to like fraction. Okay. By the help of LCM, unlike fraction converted to like fraction. Okay. Then after, it is very easy to compare to the given fraction. Now look here, your question: arrange the following fraction in increasing order. Increasing order means biggest to increasing order means smallest to biggest. So this is numerator 4, 15 and 6. In 4, 15 and 6, which is smallest? Which is smallest number? Smallest number is 4 upon 20. Okay. This is 4 upon 20. Then after, which fraction, which is your next fraction? 6 upon 20, then after 15 upon 20. Okay, that means 4 upon 20 is less than 6 upon 20. 6 upon 20 is less than 15 upon 20. Okay, but this is the incomplete answer. This is the incomplete answer. How can you complete this answer? 4 upon 20 represent 1 upon 5. Okay. 6 upon 20 represent 3 upon 10. 15 upon 20 is represent 3 upon 4. So your answer will be 1 upon 5 is less than 3 upon 10 is less than 3 upon 4. Okay, this is the required answer for the given question. Now your second question is, arrange the fraction in decreasing order. Arrange the given fraction in decreasing order. As you are looking, this is 4 upon 9, 2 upon 5 and 3 upon 7. These three fractions are unlike fraction. Unlike fraction means fraction having with different denominator are called unlike fraction. So what is your first step? First, we will take the LCM of the denominator. Okay. Now, LCM of nine, five, and seven will be 3 3s are 9. This is 5. This is 7. 3 1s are 3. This is 5 1s are 5, and this is 7. 7 1s are 7. So LCM will be 3 into 3 into 5 into 7. 3 3s are 9, 9 5s are 45, 3 3s are 9, 9 5s are 45, 45 into 7, 7 5s are 35. This is 5, carry over is 3, 7 4s are 28 plus 3, 31. 315. LCM is 315. LCM is 315. Okay. Then what will you do? This is the first fraction, 4 upon 9. Denominator is 9. Okay. And 9 we will convert it to 315. How? Look here. It is very easy procedure. Kindly keep in mind, this is 4 upon 9. Suppose this is 4 upon 9. Okay. And 9 converted to 315. So what will you do? Let it be 9. Let it be 9. Okay. Now there are two denominators, 5 and 7. 5 7 is 35. 5 7 is 35. So 4 multiplied by 35 and 9 multiplied by 35. 35 4 is 140 and 35 9 is 315. Okay. Again, second fraction is 2 upon 5. Second fraction is 2 upon 5. So 5 converted to 315. How? Let it be 5. After 5, there are two denominators, 9 and 7. 9 7 is 63. 2 into 63 upon 5 into 63. Okay. 63 2 is 126 upon 63 5 is 315. ओके, देन आफ्टर दिस इज 3/7, दिस इज 7, 7 कन्वर्टेड टू 315. हाउ वी विल अप्लाई द सेम प्रोसीजर, लेट इट बी 7. आफ्टर 7 देर आर टू डिनोमिनेटर, और बिसाइड्स बिसाइड्स 7 देर आर टू डिनोमिनेटर 9 एंड 5. 9 5s are 45. So 3 into 45 upon 7 into 45. Okay. 45 3s are 135 upon 45 7s are 315. Okay. So as you are looking, your question is in form of unlike fraction, and what will you do? By the help of LCM, unlike fraction converted to like fraction. As you are looking, this is first column and this is second column. In first column, denominators are different. In this column, denominators are different. So this is the unlike fraction. And in this column, denominators are same. That is the like fraction. Like fraction means a fraction having with same denominator. Fraction having with same denominator are called like fraction. Okay. Then after, what will you do? According to your question, arrange the fractions in decreasing order. Decreasing order means biggest to smallest. Decreasing order means biggest to smallest. So now look here. This is 140, 126 and 135. In 140, 126 and 135, which is the biggest numerator? That is 140. So first we will write 140 upon 315. Then after, which number is less than 140? That is 135. 135 is less than 315. Then after 126 is less than 135 upon 315. That means 140 upon 315 is bigger than 135 upon 315. 135 upon 315 is bigger than 126 upon 315. But this is the incomplete answer. How will you complete? Now look here. 140 upon 315. 140 upon 315 is equal to 4 upon 9. So this is 4 upon 9. Okay. 135 upon 315. 135 upon 315 is equal to 3 upon 7. Then after, 126 upon 315 is equal to 2 upon 5. So this is the required answer. 4 upon 9 is bigger than 3 upon 7. Is bigger than 2 upon 5. So this is the arranging of the fraction, arranging of the given fraction in decreasing order. Okay, this is your required answer. Let us, we will discuss about addition and subtraction of fraction. For this topic, we will come to the page number 63. Okay. Your question number 1A is 3 upon 8. plus 4 upon 8. Okay, and now look here, this is 3 upon 8 and this is 4 upon 8. As you know very well, in these two fraction denominator are equal. So this is the like fraction, and it is very easy to add these fraction. Now look here, 8 denominators are same, that is 8. So this number you can write 3 plus 4 upon 8. 3 plus 4 upon 8. 3 plus 4 means 7. 7 upon 8. That means your required answer is 7 upon 8. In question number 1B, 6 upon 13 plus 2 upon 11. As you are looking, this is the unlike fraction. Okay, this is the unlike fraction. And how we will add unlike fraction? We will apply the same procedure. First, we will take the LCM of the denominator. So, LCM of 13 and 11. LCM of 13 and 11 will be, this is 11, 11 1 is 11, and 13 1 is 13. 11 into 13. LCM of 13 and 11 is 143. So what will you do? In first fraction denominator is 13, and 13 converted to 143. How? Look here, 6 upon 13 converted to 143. How? Look here, this is 13, second denominator is 11. That means 6 into 11 upon 13 into 11. 11 6 is 66, 13 into 11, it will give to you 143. Okay, now this is 2 upon 11. 11 we will convert it to 143. How? Look here, beside 11 other denominator is 13. So 2 multiplied by 13 upon 11 into 13. 13 to the 26 upon 11 into 13, it will give to you 143. Okay, then after 6 upon 13 is equal to 66 upon 43. 66 upon 143 plus, so we take here plus 2 upon 11. 2 upon 11 is represent 26 upon 143. So what will you do? 66 plus 26. As you are looking, denominators are same. So we can write 66 plus 26 upon 143. 66 plus 26 is equal to 92 upon 143. 92 upon 143. This is the required answer. 92 upon 143 is required answer for the given question. Your next question is question number 2C. Subtract 7, 4 upon 12 minus 3 and 1 upon 3. Okay. Subtract 7 and 4 upon 12 minus 3 and 1 upon 3. How can you subtract these two fractions? As you are looking, this is the mixed fraction. This is the mixed fraction. Okay. And mixed fraction easily we will convert it to improper fraction. Mixed fraction easily we will convert it to improper fraction. Okay. Seven and four upon 12. So seven and four upon 12 is equal to 4 1 4, 4 3 12. 4 1 4, 4 3 12. This number you can write 7 and 1 upon 3. Okay. So this is the mixed fraction, and mixed fraction converted to improper fraction. Now look here, this is 7 and 4 upon 12. 4 upon 12 easily we can do in simplest form. 4 1 is 4, 4 3 is 12. You can write here 7 and 1 upon 3. This is mixed fraction. Mixed fraction converted to easily in improper fraction. How? Look here. 3 7 is 21. 7 into 3 plus 1 upon 3. 7 3 is 21. 21 plus 1. 7 3 is 21 plus 1 upon 3. 21 plus 1, it will give to you 22 upon 3. Okay. That means 7 and 4 upon 12. 7 and 4 upon 12, we can convert it to 22 upon 3. Okay. Then after, this is 3 and 1 upon 3. It is improper, it is mixed fraction. 3 and 1 upon 3 is mixed fraction, and mixed fraction we will convert it to improper fraction. We apply the same procedure. 3 into 3 plus 1 upon 3. Okay. 3 3 is 9 plus 1 upon 3. 9 plus 1, 10 upon 3. Okay, so what you are looking, 7 and 4 upon 12 converted to 22 upon 3. 22 upon 3 minus 3 and 1 upon 3 converted to 10 upon 3. As you are looking, 22 upon 3 and 10 upon 3. Denominators are same. Denominators are same. That means denominators are same. That means this is the like fraction. This is the like fraction. Easily we can subtract 22 minus 10 upon 3. 22 minus 12. 12 upon 3. 12 upon 3 means 4. Answer is 4. Okay. 4 is required answer for the given question. Your question number 3 is add 5 upon 12. Add 5 upon 12 to the difference of 1, 1 upon 4 and 2 and 5 upon 6. Okay. Add 5 upon 12 to the difference of 1 and 1 upon 4 and 2 and 5 upon 6. As you are looking, this is 1 and 1 upon 4. It is the mixed fraction. And mixed fraction we can convert it to improper fraction. We apply the same procedure. 1 into 4 plus 1 upon 4. 4 1 ja 4 plus 1 upon 4. That means 5 upon 4. Okay. Then after 2 and 5 upon 6, 2 into 6 plus 5 upon 6, 2 6 are 12 plus 5 upon 6, that means 17 upon 6. Okay, so 1 and 1 upon 4 converted to 5 upon 4, 2 and 5 upon 6 converted to 17 upon 6. Okay, now let us we will discuss about what is the difference between in these two fraction. What is the difference between in these two fraction? So now look here, 17 upon 6, according to question, difference of these two fraction means in 5 upon 4 and 17 upon 6. In 5 upon 4 and 17 upon 6, which is the bigger fraction? Bigger fraction is 17 upon 6. So 17 upon 6 minus 5 upon 4. Okay, 17 upon 6 and 5 upon 4, this is the unlike fraction. And unlike fraction we can convert it to like fraction by the help of LCM. Okay, so now look here, LCM of 6 and 4. LCM of 6 and 4 will be 2 3 is 6, 2 2 is 4, 2 1 is 2, and 3 1 is 3. 2 2 is 4, 4 3 is 12. LCM is 12. LCM is 12. Okay, now there are denominator is 6. So what will you do? 6 converted to 12. 6 converted to 12. How? 6 2 is 12. 17 into 2 upon 6 into 2. 17 into the 34 upon 6 to the 12. Okay. Then after this is 5 upon 4. 4 3 is 12. 5 into 3 upon 4 into 3. 5 3 is 15 and 4 3 is 12. Okay. That means what is the fraction of these two? What is the difference of these two fraction? Thirty-four upon 12 minus 15 upon 12. As you are looking, 34 upon 12 and 15 upon 12, this is the like fraction. Easily we can subtract 34 minus 15 upon 12. That means it will give to you 19 upon 12. Okay, 19 upon 12. But this is incomplete answer. Then what will you do? 19 upon 12 we will add in 5 upon 12. That means your question is add 5 upon 12 to the difference of 1 and 1 upon 4 and 2 and 5 upon 6. So difference between these two fraction is 19 upon 12. In 19 upon 12 we will add 5 upon 12. Okay, so 19 upon 12 we will add in 5 upon 12. Okay, so now look here, denominators are same. It will give to you 19 plus 5 upon 12. 19 plus 5, 24 upon 12. 24 upon 12. Easily we can convert it in simplest form. 12 1 is 12, 12 2 is 24. 12 1 is 12, 12 2 is 24. That means your Required answer is 2. Your next topic is multiplication of fraction. That means how will you find out the product of the two or more than two fractions. Please come to the page number 69. Your question number 1 is find the value of each of the following. Find the value of each of the following. Now look here, in question number 1a, 2 upon 5 into 20, okay? Now look here, 2 upon 5, 2 upon 5 is proper fraction and 20 is whole number. That means this question depends on multiplication of proper fraction to the whole number. Multiplication of proper fraction and whole number. So what will you do? 2 upon 5 is proper fraction and 20 is whole number. And whole number we can convert it to fractional form. How? 20 we can write here 20 upon 1. Okay. Then after what will you do? Multiply by numerator to numerator and denominator to denominator. 2 into 20 upon 5 into 1. Okay. Now look here, 20 2's are 40 and 5 1's are 5. Okay, so 40 upon 5 easily we can convert it to simplest form. 5 1's are 5 5 8's are 40. This is 8 upon 1. So answer is 8. 8 is your required answer for the given question. Okay. Now question number 1b. This is question number 1b. 9 into 3 upon 5. 9 into 3 upon 5. Now look here. 9 is whole number. 9 is whole number. And 3 upon 5 is proper fraction. So what will you do? 9 we will convert it to fractional form. 9 we can write here 9 upon 1. Okay. 9 we can write here 9 upon 1. Then after multiplied by numerator to numerator and denominator to denominator. So 9 into 3 upon 1 into 5. 9 3's are 27 and 5 1's are 5. Okay. 9 3's are 27 and 5 1's are 5. 27 upon 5 is incomplete answer. That's why 27 upon 5 is improper fraction. Keep in mind, 27 upon 5 is improper fraction, okay? And improper fraction easily we can convert it to mixed fraction by the help of division procedure. Now look here, 5 5's are 25, 27 minus 25, it will give to you 2. That means this 5 is called divisor. This 5 is called divisor. This 5 is called quotient. Okay. And 2 is remainder. 2 is remainder. So this is improper fraction. And improper fraction easily we can convert it to mixed fraction by the help of division. Now look here. So this is Q, this is R and this is D. D stands for divisor, Q stands for quotient and R stands for remainder. So what will you do? Easily 27 27 upon 5 we can write in the form of, now look here, 5 and 2 upon 7, 5 and 2 upon 5, okay, 5 and 2 upon 5. Please keep in mind in one formula QRD. This is Q. Q stands for quotient, R stands for remainder, and D stands for divisor. So this is Q. This 5 is Q. This 2 is remainder, and this 5 is divisor. Okay, QR upon D. So your required answer is 5 and 2 upon 5. Okay, this is the required answer. Your next question is 3 upon 7 into 3 upon 4. As you know very well, this question depends on proper fraction multiplied by proper fraction. 3 upon 7 is proper fraction and 3 upon 4 is proper fraction. So what will you do? In this type of question, multiplied by numerator to numerator and denominator to denominator. So multiplied by numerator to numerator and denominator to denominator. Okay. So 3 3s are 9 and 7 4s are 28. 3 3s are 9 and 7 4s are 28. Answer is 9 upon 28. 9 upon 28 is your required answer. Now question number 1E. 2 1 upon 4. 2 and 1 upon 4 into 3 upon 7. So what will you do? 2 and 1 upon 4. This is mixed fraction. And this is proper fraction. That means in this question we will find out the product, and this question depends on multiplication of mixed fraction with proper fraction. Multiplication of mixed fraction with proper fraction. So what will you do? This is mixed fraction, and mixed fraction converted to improper fraction. We apply the same procedure. 4 2s are 8, 4 2s are 8, 8 plus 1, 9, 9 upon 4, okay, 4 2s are 8 plus 1, 9 upon 4 into, this is 3 upon 7, okay, then after we apply the same procedure, multiplied by numerator to numerator and denominator to denominator. 9 into 3 upon 4 into 7. 9 3s are 27 and 4 7s are 28. 27 upon 28, this is your required answer. 9 3s are 27, 4 7s are 28. 27 upon 28 is your required answer. Then after question number 1F, 2 and 1 upon 7 into 1F is 2 and 1 upon 7 into 2 upon 3 into 1 upon 4. Okay. Now look here. First, what will you do? This is 2 and 1 upon 7. Okay. 2 and 1 upon 7 is mixed fraction, and a mixed fraction converted to improper fraction. We apply the same procedure. 7 2s are 14. 7 2s are 14. 14 plus 1, 15. This fraction we can write 15 upon 7 into 2 upon 3 into 1 upon 4. Okay. Then after what we need to do? Multiply with numerator to numerator and denominator to denominator. So now look here. 15 into 2 into 1 upon 7 into 3 into 4. Okay. In this type of question, we can apply the simplest form. That means this is 2 and this is 4. This is 2 and this is 4. 2 and 4 easily we can convert it to simplest form. How? Look here. 2 1s are 2, 2 2s are 4. 2 1s are 2, 2 2s are 4. Okay. And this is 3, this is 15. 3 1s are 3, 3 5s are 15. 3 1s are 3, 3 5s are 15. Okay. Then after, yes, 5 into 1 into 1. 5 into 1 into 1 upon 7 into 1 into 2. So 5 1s are 5 and 7 2s are 14. That means 5 upon 14 is required answer. Again I will explain. This is 2 and 1 upon 7. 2 and 1 upon 7 is mixed fraction. And mixed fraction easily we can convert it to improper fraction. 7 2s are 14. 14 plus 1, 15. 15 upon 7 into 2 upon 3 into 1 upon 4. Okay. Then after what will you do? Multiply with numerator to numerator and denominator to denominator. So as you are looking, 15 into 2 into 1. 15 into 2 into 1 upon 7 into 3 into 4. Okay. Then after we can apply the simplest form. That means if any number will be cancelled, it will be cancelled. 2 and 4. 2 1s are 2, 2 2s are 4. This is 15, this is 3. 3 1s are 3, 3 5s are 15. Then after we will find out the product of the remaining number according to numerator and denominator. So 5 into 1 into 1 upon 7 into 1 into 2. 5 1 is 5, 7 2 is 14. Answer is 5 upon 14. That means 5 upon 14 is required answer. Your question number 2 is, Sonal has 120 buttons. 2 upon 3 of the buttons are red. How many red buttons does she have? That means in this question, the solution of the given question is, Sonal has how many buttons? Sonal has 120 buttons. Okay. Sonal has 120 buttons. Now, out of 120 buttons, only 2 upon 3 of the buttons, 2 upon 3 of the 120 buttons are red. That means 2 upon 3 buttons are red. 2 upon 3 buttons are red out of 120. So in this question we will find out how many red buttons does she have. How many red buttons does she have? So number of red buttons will be number of red buttons will be 120 into 2 upon 3, okay. 120 is whole number, 2 upon 3 is proper fraction. 120 we can write here 120 upon 1, okay. And this is 120 and this is 3. Now look here. So what will you do? Multiply by numerator with numerator and denominator with denominator. 120 into 2 upon 1 into 3. Okay. So this is 120 and this is 3. Easily we can cancel. 3 ones are 3. 3 fours are 12 and this is 0. Okay. 43 is 120. 120 upon 3, it will give to you 40. Then after what will you do? 40 into 2. 40 into 2 is equal to 80. 42 is 80. That means number of red buttons. Total number of red buttons will be 80. This is your required answer. Your question number 3 is, each side of a square is 4 upon 5 meter. Find the area of the square. What is the meaning of a square? Please keep in mind, a square is one geometrical figure. A square is one geometrical figure which having all sides are equal. Okay, as you are looking in this figure, ABCD is a square which having all sides are equal, and measurement of each side is 4 upon 5 meter. Okay, in this question we will find the area of the square. Area of the square. What is the formula for area of the square? Area of the square is equal to side into side. Side into side. And each side will be in same measurement. Each side will be in same measurement. So this is 4 upon 5 into 4 upon 5. What will you do? Multiply with numerator to numerator, denominator to denominator. So 4 into 4 upon 5 into 5. 4 4s are 16, 5 5s are 25. 16 upon 25 meter square. 16 upon 25 meter square is the required answer for the given question. That means the area of the given square is 16 upon 25 meter square. This is the required answer for the given question. Answer is 16 upon 25 meter square. Your next question is, the cost of 1 kg of rice is rupees 92. The cost of 1 kg of rice is rupees 92. What is the cost of 3.5 kg of rice? So in this type of question we will apply the unitary method. Okay, what is the solution for this question? Now look here, the cost of one kg of rice is rupees 92. The cost of 1 kg of rice is rupees 92. So in this question we will find out the cost of 3.5 kg. 3.5 kg of fries will be, what will you do? The cost of 1 kg of rice is rupees 92. Then the cost of 3.5 kg of rice will be 3.5 multiplied by 92. Okay. Now let us, we will discuss about the solution. 3 and 1 upon 2 into 92. 92 we can write here, 92 upon 1. Okay. This is 3.5 kg. This is 3 and 1 upon 2 is mixed fraction. 3 and 1 upon 2 is mixed fraction. And mixed fraction converted to improper fraction. How? 2, 3 is 6. 6 plus 1, 7. 2, 3 is 6. 6 plus 1, 7. 7 upon 2 into 92 upon 1. Okay. Then after what will you do? We will apply the multiplication, numerator to numerator and denominator to denominator. 7 into 92 upon 2 into 1. Okay. 7 into 92 upon 2 into 1. This is 92 and this is 2. 92 easily divided by 2. Or 92 is easily cancelled by 2. 2 1 is 2. 2 4 is 8. 9 minus 8 1 and 2 6 is 12. That is 46. 46 into 7 will be 7 6 is 42. This is 42. Carry over is 4. 7 4 is 28. 28 plus 4, 32. Okay. So 322. 92 is divisible by 2, it will give to you 46. 46 into 7. 46 into 7, it will give to you 322. That means rupees 322 is the required answer. That means the cost of 3.5 kg of rice will be 322 rupees. Rupees 322 is the cost of 3.5 kg of rice. Okay. This is the required answer for the given question. My dear students, all these questions and basic points depend on your book. I hope that it will be very useful to you for your knowledge and upcoming exam. Thank you. God bless you.